It's Omar Wale. I got a thing here about this slavery thing. I see it going around. I approached it before, not in this situation, but here we go. Slavery did not start in 1619 in the United States of America. It started long before that. Next thing is this. Slavery was not like you thinking about the Kunta Kinte thing until the 1800s. Because this. Slavery started as a bond situation. So in the 1619, whatever that was, those people were bonded. They were indentured servants. They pay off their bond, they done. And America wasn't like every nigga is a slave at that time. That came slowly. It took almost 100 years for that to happen. That didn't just jump out of the box. Niggas would have made a big stink. They brought that over a period of time. First, it was 5-year indenture. Then it became 7-year indenture. This was Iwafa territory where what people say the African kings were trading slaves and shit, where they were doing business with Iwafa. These people had debt. They were debt slaves, as they call them. That means bond. They were bonded. So then I'll tell you how that thing worked, because you know how it worked. You're just mixed up because it's such a narrative out this making everything crazy. So now I'm telling you how this thing goes. They come over. Some people came over just on a gig. I found them people that came over on gigs. They would stay 3, 5, and 7-year gigs, get their pay, and leave. They weren't bonded. They weren't indentured or nothing. They came on that same ship, 1619, free men. They came to do a gig. The ones I found were horse trainers. They trained horses. They broke horses and stuff like that. And their family had been doing that in America before 1619. Their family had been, the family I'm talking about of the horse breeders, they came over. Twice I found their generation had come over. I mean, their family had come over to do that gig, a 3 to 5 year gig, breaking horses, and they go back home. And the ship was moving then. We had our own ships moving in some of them cases. Our people around, not no slave ships and all that, our own, not no European or nobody. We moved ourselves around. All right, so stop. I mean, not to stop, but I'm trying to give you an idea of what's going on. All right, okay, so over a period of years and left delegations and litigation and stuff like that, they came up with this slavery that you think about where every nigga is a slave. Okay, that's not so. Even they tell you, they say, I heard, because I follow rumors. So I heard that one of the biggest slave owners in Virginia was a nigger. He owned slaves. And I said, no kidding. So I went and found him. No, this is later. Now I'll get back to him, though, for real. What happened was they say Africans were selling slaves to the Europeans. So I said, no kidding. So I went and searched, and I found them. Those people, okay, in 1801, they sent a letter to England because they had just found, that took them almost 30 years to find out how bad the English people were treating the people when they came over here. Remember, they didn't have internet and all that crazy stuff. Just to move a ship off from here to there took 3 months. That's how long shipping wasn't like it is now with the boat and all that stuff and you fly. And then no, it took a long time and they didn't get the information of how our people were being treated overseas until later. They forced the Queen of England to abolish slavery. She's slick, you know. So she abolished slavery as a cover politically. It was three brothers. One of them was now Yoruba. His name was Adeyemi. Some other brothers. I don't remember their name, but Adeyemi stays with me because I knew a brother named Adeyemi. Okay, so anyway. But one of the kings that was doing that, as you call slave trade, they were doing business just like any. Okay, somebody trade the New York Knicks for the Boston, whatever them teams are. And they trade people. They nobody. Oh, I found out they were treating my people bad over there. So I took my people. Then they told the Queen of England to stop it. 2 years later, she put out this thing, 1803, to stop it. Okay, fine. That's what happened with that, as far as people finding out about how the people were being mistreated in the Americas and every other place they were being taken. The African kings did not know, and when they did know, they protested. So y'all jump on them if you want to. Jump on them if you want to. I finished that particular part. Now I'm going to go to this nigga that's supposed to own slaves in Virginia. He did. He owned, I think, in excess of 15 slaves as one person. And that Virginia at that time was nobody was even close to him in the ownership of slaves. Let me tell you this. Seven of them was his direct family. He bought their bond. That's when the nigga could buy. He bought his own bond. He, because it wasn't, no, you can't do nothing, everything mine. That came over a period of time. You even in Kunta, whatever movies, the guy was working extra with the fiddle and stuff. So he was getting extra money. He could buy his own bond and do his thing. And this dude, the one that owned all these slaves, he bought his own bond. He bought his mom's bond. He bought his wife, his brother, and his sister's bond. And so he owned them bonds. And as such, he was known as a slave owner. He bought his friend's bond. He bought his friend's bond. And I hear people talk about, well, nigga, this and that. Got all derogatory about this man, and he was great. Anyway, that was before they did this whole Jim Crow thing and all the rest of that stuff. All of this stuff took time, like it's taking time now. They're still progressing with this kind of, like, okay, they're doing the thing with the voting. I don't know. That's up to y'all. Y'all want to participate? That's your game. What I'm doing is telling you, this thing did not happen all at once. It was progressive, and we are and have always been involved in it. So you don't think, oh, how did they do this and how did they do that? This part about slavery is all I'm covering right now because I don't like to get long-winded into these things. Just tell you what's up. Thank you.